science of engineering is about to undergo a fundamental seismic shift: artificial intelligence. AI, and more specifically generative design, well, it promises to change literally everything about engineering, from basic ideation to rendering to product development. Join me and five experts on the next episode of the Engineering Roundtable. Here's an excerpt of our conversation.
So I definitely think there's room for both computer and human designer. So, for example, the human still has a place in deciding what a problem is and which problems are worth solving. And that's usually a societal or even personal driver. Once the problem's been identified, the next challenge is to work out, well, what does good look like? What measures good? And then to pass it over to something that's driven by a computer, you really need to put that into an algorithmic form. You need to enumerate it. I tend to think about what a generative design system should do rather than what it is. And I think two really useful outputs are, there should be some element of surprise. If it doesn't produce anything surprising, it's fairly pointless. Or it should alleviate some of the tedious tasks that would prevent a designer from following a certain path. If something is simply just too complicated to imagine or design, the chances are they won't design it. So if it does either or both of those things, I think you have something useful in this generative framework.
Tomas, you're in the injection molding industry. That is mass production. Where does this kind of advanced design methodologies fit in?
So what we right now basically use in terms of generative design is the topology optimization part of it. Yes. But we use this in most of our projects to save weight, to save money for our customers, and also to get to reach our goals in terms of strains, fatigue, and so on, or stress criteria.
Jigs and fixtures are vitally important for any manufacturing process, but they're very little talked about. GD and that world.
So what we are trying in our organization is to go against the conception of blockbusting. So everything has been done like this, so we must continue like this. That is the wall that we are trying to break and go beyond. And the first application that we found indeed is fixture, tools, jigs, because there are a number of possibilities there that are huge.